What is the Oort Cloud? Do you care? Yes, you do. Let me tell you why. The Oort Cloud is a vast swarm of some 2 trillion comets orbiting our star at the most distant reaches of our solar system, at the extreme outer edge of the sun's gravitational pull, if you will. The Oort Cloud was discovered by a Dutch astronomer who just so happened to share its name. If memory serves me correctly, a certain Jan Hendrik Oort. Mr. Oort first detected the effects of this nebulous cloud in 1950 during his work at the Leiden Observatory. The Oort Cloud can be divided into 3 separate categories: the outer Oort Cloud, which is very far away, the inner Oort Cloud, which is still very far away, and the Kuiper Belt, which is practically in our backyard, but is still extremely far away. There. You can stop watching now. That was the brief overview of the Oort Cloud. If your minuscule attention span is still engaged, let's join a live science professional.
Wait, wait, wait! I am not ready yet!
Well, do hurry up. We only have 3 minutes to explain this incredibly complicated subject.
Yeah. Hello, I am a scientist. This is you. This is your knowledge about the Oort Cloud. This is nothing. The Oort Cloud is a very big place that probably doesn't exist. There, now your nothing is something. This is Earth. This is our solar system. And this is the Kuiper Belt. The Kuiper Belt extends in a big disc shape surrounding all of our planets, full of large frozen things made up of methane, ammonia, and water. And Pluto. Pluto lives here in the Kuiper Belt and not here with the planets. The Kuiper Belt is the only part of the Oort Cloud that we have ever observed. The inner and the outer layers of the Oort Cloud are just too far away and space is really, really big. But just because we cannot see it doesn't mean it doesn't exist. Now, the inner layer of the Oort Cloud is a big fat donut shape far away from the Kuiper Belt, all the way to approximately 5,000 astronomical units away. 1 astronomical unit is the distance from the Earth to the Sun approximately. Now, if you think that that is far away, hold on to your pants, because the outer layer of the Oort Cloud could be as far away as 1 light year from our sun. The outer layer is a big sphere surrounding our solar system. Let me put this distance into perspective. Alpha Centauri is the closest star to our sun at just over 4 light years away. The Oort Cloud is 1/4 the way to another star. Isn't that exciting?
Yes. But perhaps we should mention that this is all highly theoretical. We have only observed the possible effects of the Oort Cloud. In fact, recent discoveries have cast doubt on the current models of the Oort Cloud entirely. Well, it looks like my time is up. If I had more time, I would tell you interesting facts like NASA's Voyager 1 spacecraft, traveling at its current velocity of 1 million miles a day, will not enter the Oort Cloud for another 300 years, and will not travel beyond it for perhaps 30,000 years. Now it's your turn. Do you believe that the Oort Cloud exists? Partake in our survey right here and let me know in the comments. But if you say that Pluto is a real planet, I will kick your butt. Cheerio, what? Till next time, for destructive creativity, I am the narrator.
Oh, don't forget to tell them to go check out this video over here that does a really good job of explaining exactly how big the Oort Cloud is. It is very, very big.